Here is a quick guide on how to use the Pro View Transforms LUT pack in Resolve. This pack of LUTs kindly shared by Joe Genco contains the best freely available DRTs, or display rendering transforms like 2499 and its variants, AgX, Kraken, Filmic, AgX the Resolve version, and many other view transforms like OpenDRT and more. Including, of course, the vanilla Blender's AgX. And now you can use all of these view transforms in DaVinci Resolve to grade your OpenEXR footages, presumably rendered in Blender. As you probably know, the EXRs imported into Resolve look totally wrong by default, due to this format not storing any color management data. So, while in Blender it may look okay, but then you choose OpenEXR, probably half float, and then some compression like DWAA to save some space. So when you do it and then go simply render animation, what happens is that the EXR exporter will ignore the color management data, whatever it was set in Blender, AGX, Filmic or Kronos. Basically, this entire color management panel will be ignored. And here enters this Pro View Transforms LUT pack, which is one of the quickest way to add any view transforms available in Blender and many more to these non-color managed raw EXRs in Resolve, which of course isn't the only way to do it, just a pretty quick and effortless one. To install these LUTs, all we need to do is come over to the Color tab in Resolve, then expand the LUTs tab at the top so we actually see the list of these lookup table files. Then I have already downloaded and installed these LUTs into a special folder, so I have it all there. All the sweet view transforms, AGX, Filmic and more. The way you can install it is super simple. You can actually just right-click any folder, the root folder for instance, and open file location. Then all you need to do is create a new folder in there and paste the LUT files. I mean the stuff that you have downloaded from our Patreon and unpacked. After creating a new folder and pasting the files, right-click any folder in here and hit refresh. And after that you should see the newly added folder with all these LUTs. Then one cannot simply start throwing LUTs onto the corrector node like that right away, because that wouldn't work. So let me reset the node grade from the right-click menu. Okay, we will need two corrector nodes. So what we need to do first is actually use this linear rec 709 to arilog c4 LUT, which converts the EXR's linear rec 709 encoding to a logarithmic one. That is necessary to make it all work. When adding LUTs to any corrected node, the grid icon will pop up, and on hovering the cursor over this icon, you can see that this node in fact is now holding a LUT. Okay, alternatively, instead of using this technical LUT, what we can do is go effects and use the color space transform effect instead, which is arguably a slightly higher quality option. The input color space should be rec 709, input gamma linear, as we are dealing with EXRs here. The output color space should be ary wide gamut 4 and output gamma ary log c4, as these are the outputs the Pro View Transforms LUTs expect, and no tone mapping. That would give us pretty much the same result as using this linear rec 709 LUT. I'll delete this effect though, and we'll close the effects tab. Now let me tidy up the nodes for you. No time for a coffee. And still, I'll just use this LUT to show you how fast it can be. Swoosh, here goes the first LUT, and then for the second corrector node, we can go ahead and try any of these view transforms. How about the vanilla Blender AGX? Easy! That's AGX for you right in Resolve. To finish off that setup, I'll rename the nodes first from the right-click menu, DRT and log. The only component that is still missing is the exposure control. For that, what we can do is make use of one more node, plugged at the start of the chain, exposure, Then, as you might know already, the way we can adjust the exposure of EXRs in Resolve is simply by manipulating the end of the RGB curve like that, or by using the gain wheel. Okay, that concludes the setup. Again, you can tell that the node holds some LUT by hovering the cursor over this grid icon. You know, it's pretty easy to forget you have applied LUTs to a node, so this could be helpful. If you want to save some time applying the LUTs, instead of dragging them, you can simply double-click. So you can see, it's a pretty quick turnaround indeed. This collection includes the view transforms used in Blender, like Filmic and AgX, each of which develops the EXR colors slightly differently, similar to how different chemicals and film development led to distinct artistic results, I guess. I encourage you to try them all, including the slightly more artistically tinted versions, like 2499, print emulation, and so on. But not only, these are all super good DRTs indeed. To apply this setup to other clips really quickly without recreating all of that, just open the Clips tab first. Right here. Select the clip you want to copy this grade to, then use the middle mouse button click to copy the grade. Just don't forget to correct the exposure if needed, as every shot naturally requires an individual approach in that sense. Now I do have time for some coffee. This was a quick guide as for how to install and use the Pro View Transforms LUTs in Resolve. Of course, there are many different ways to color manage the EXR data in this software. Strictly speaking, we don't have to resort to LUTs only. Anyway, if you want to give it a try, that's how you do it. Shout out to Joe Genco for baking this LUT pack from the Pixelmanager OCIO config that is freely available on GitHub. Pixelmanager is the one OCIO configuration to rule them all, which can be used in Blender and other software to greatly extend the selection of the view transforms available. An incredible work indeed. Pixelmanager. Alright, the ProView Transforms loot pack is available on our Creative Shrimp Patreon page if you haven't downloaded it yet. And obviously it's also included with the resources of the Blender to Resolve video course that is available on our Gumroad.